heading to collect the asset. Assets in the air. Thank you. Collecting asset. Heading to pick up the asset. Asset collection request received. Asset in transit. Asset transportation underway. En route to pick up the asset. Asset to be collected. En route to collect the asset. Delivery has been completed. Asset transportation in progress. Asset transportation complete. Asset has been collected. Asset has been delivered. Transportation underway. Transporting asset. Delivery complete. Transit. Asset requiring collection. Acknowledging asset collection request. Picking up asset. Collecting asset. Acknowledging asset collection request. Confirmed. Transit has commenced. Transit. Transit has commenced. Asset in transit. Transporting asset. Asset being transported. En route to pick up the asset. Asset collection request received. Asset transportation in progress. Underway. Asset has been collected. Assets in the air. Asset transportation underway. En route to collect the asset. Asset has been collected. Transportation complete. Asset transportation in progress.
This facility, it's remarkable.
You can say that again.
Let's call it a biosyn sanctuary.
Although that does sound like marketing rather than reality.
Well, reality is the one we make, right?
Even if it isn't accurate?
These dinosaurs are an asset to the world, one we need to share with it. However, we do this on our terms and our timelines.
We've done our best for the dinosaurs and for Biosyn. We did our jobs and we did them well. This is no time to be looking back.
Then we look forward to all the possibilities that we are about to share with the world.
To the future of Biosyn Genetics.
Spearheaded by Lewis Dodgson, Biosyn Genetics ushered in a new era of bioengineering, building a utopia for their dinosaur creations. But in the shadows, Dodgson was devising a more sinister plan. They were engineering prehistoric locusts, capable of destroying any crop or farmland not using Biosyn seeds. Doctors Ellie Sattler and Alan Grant discovered their plans and infiltrated Biosyn's restricted research area. They were able to collect the DNA evidence they needed to prove Biosyn's nefarious intent. Attempting to cover his tracks, Dodgson destroyed the evidence, causing a catastrophe in the valley. He would meet his own demise as a raging inferno tore through the area, putting all life at risk. Fortunately, most of the dinosaurs were saved and the fire was contained. The valley, however, remains a scorched landscape in need of healing, with Biosyn's legacy left hanging in the balance. wasn't expecting it to be this bad.
With Dotson out of the picture, the future could hold something amazing.
Such as?
A permanent, viable home for the dinosaurs.
I like the sound of that, Owen. We do have the experience to take this on.
There's one thing we don't do, it's easy.
You can say that again.
To really get this right, I think we're gonna need some help.
Funny you should mention that. I have just the right people in mind.
When I think about everything, what really gets me the most is seeing these animals injured. The buildings, bank accounts, and egos can be rebuilt, but a dinosaur is a walking miracle of evolution and science.
They really are a miracle. Born of science and dogged determination. And sadly, a lot of sacrifice, too.
And we can't let that be for nothing. Where do we start?
We triage the situation. Find the dinosaurs most in need of medical care and treat them first.
Agreed. Then we focus on repairing what we can. It looks like the fire damage is minimal in some places.
Sounds good. Let's get started.
We should get the essential systems back first. Let's start by repairing the hydropower hub.
Yes, right. Energy is the first step towards getting us back up and running.
Exactly. We sort that out, and we get our core buildings operational again.
Can't move any dinosaurs captured by the DFW at the moment.
Well, that's not good.
So, what do we do?
Wait for better weather. Why risk anything? You know what happens when we rush something.
Yeah, well, I see your point.
Owen, remember when you said we're gonna need help?
Which time? The time the park fell apart, the time we were chased by my own raptors, the time the volcano went off and we had to run down the hill? Well, you rolled, but
I get it. You know what I meant. Anyways, help has arrived. You remember Dr. Sattler and Dr. Grant?
After all we've been through? Yes. Yes, I do.
I just can't believe we're all back here again. How can we help?
Right now, we could use some more personnel. Specifically, scientists.
I might know 100 or 200. We're gonna need anyone specializing in paleontology or paleobiology.
Or paleobotany. We pretty much know them all.
You know, it's amazing that a lifetime of studying dinosaurs might just get you noticed, but run from a few and you're kind of a rock star.
Ellie, why are we here? Really, what are we doing? I made a promise to myself I would never, never get mixed up in this business again. And yet...
I know, but once you see these magnificent creatures, you really feel the history of this planet, its life, its ecosystem. I wouldn't miss that for the world.
I know, but there's always that underlying need to get ready to run.
Well, yes, there is that, but can we just take in the good parts for now? Your life's work is living all around us.
Yep. Still gets my heart beating.
Look at this outcome. Look at these dinosaurs. Don't you wish Ian could be here with us?
No.
Well, we wouldn't let him drive. Now, we've got some debris blocking the dinosaurs. I think if we could open up a path through this part of the facility, the dinosaurs could reach a lot more usable space.
Okay. I'm guessing we could do that by cleaning up this section of scorched earth here. It'll give them a little breathing room, but it won't be easy.
Are you ready for a hard day's work?
Well, you know me. Ready when you are.
There's a good stretch of beautiful land in the valley, untouched and perfect for the dinosaurs. But to get them there, we'll need to move the animals through a lot of fire-damaged forest. Here's the path that Ellie and Alan laid out.
Many of the dinosaurs have the instinct to move in herds, in packs. We convince a few and the others will follow, even the solitary animals. Once they see a large migration, they'll be tempted to tag along.
And the predators will go where their food does.
They always do. Okay, so how about we mobilize our ranger teams to wrangle them through the path? It'll be like a cattle drive, but with vehicles, and the cows weigh 8 tons.